Rolling, rolling, rolling. Oh, my butt is swollen. Think we'll just go bowling next year. No highway beating. Pizza will be eaten. Think we'll just go bowling next year.
They are riding 850 miles from Utah to the Mexican border. They're pretty sure it's uphill all the way.
I've discovered that me and this state have irreconcilable differences.
They are doctors, lawyers, no Indian chiefs in sight, but plenty of successful business owners.
Bob Kite has a big fanny and is great to draft behind, but it's not as good as this car.
They call themselves guardian warriors.
A true warrior, true courage, is lifting somebody up. It's easy to knock somebody down, but it takes true courage to lift somebody up.
Gil Gillenwater is their leader.
These are the modern day warriors right here.
And they are on a mission.
If you can imagine it, you can create it. And that's what we're doing here. We're taking a portion of our lives and we're saying, hey, this world needs some changes. And instead of complaining about it and saying we're victims and blaming the government, we're getting off our dead asses and putting them on a bike seat and making a difference.
They are making a difference here in the Mexican border town of Agua Prieta, across from Douglas, Arizona. These orphans, old folks, and nuns have a place to live because of the guardian warriors from Gil's Rancho Feliz charity. They are making a difference feeding 300 children a day at this soup kitchen. Felix will have legs, others eyesight or glasses or cleft palate surgery.
Felix says that getting his artificial limbs makes him stronger and gives him more valor to be able to work.
Remember what we're doing here, we're riding for those kids down in Mexico. Let's ride to Mexico.
They raise hell and cash for kids. Today is the payoff. After 9 days on the road, the warriors will meet the children they're riding for and see the buildings their efforts have created.
We're all ready for this. We're done in. Deep fried, pan fried, chicken fried, fried beyond all recognition. That's us.
To actually see it, to see the bricks and mortar, you know, and see the smiles on those little kids' faces and the senior citizens, that's gonna be worth $1 million.
Rollin', 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 the butts are not so swollen. Harleys are a-rollin', they're here. Riding to the border, Santa's got the order. Presents for the children this year.
The cyclists will meet up with other guardian warriors on Harleys for Rancho Feliz's annual Christmas in October celebration across the border.
Feliz Navidad.
Here.
This is Gil's dream, and he's allowing us to share it, but his energy and his charisma is what created this.
Gil has affected more people's lives positively than anyone I have ever known. I am staggered by it.
Give him a round of applause in spirit anyway.
Gil's dream began modestly enough 12 Thanksgivings ago. He figured he had a lot to be thankful for. So he and his brother Troy loaded their car with food in Scottsdale, Arizona, and headed south. They found an orphanage with no indoor plumbing.
They can't even take a shower. They don't even have a toilet. And I thought, this is ridiculous. Here I'm in a culture up there in Scottsdale, Arizona, where I spend more on one dinner, one date, than these people will spend in a month or 6 months.
Gil, this is all the sewer line, water storage?
Yep.
So Gil, a successful land developer, invited his buddies to a party and raised some money to get plumbing for the orphanage. Rancho Feliz was born.
And it just snowballed from there. And the neat thing is that once you get involved in service work,
amazing things start happening in your life. You enter another dimension where coincidences happen. That deal you were working on, it finally closes, and the check shows up in the mail. And then you start realizing, hey, wait a minute. And this might sound conditional, but I don't care. I call it secular ethics. It works. It's a cosmic law, if you will, that when you do good things for people, when you're in that service mode, good things happen to you.
The idea was with the kids here and the senior citizens there, the seniors could look out and see the children playing.
Rancho Feliz works with groups in Mexico to build projects that help those who are too young or too old or too sick to help themselves. Still, to eat at this soup kitchen, kids must go to school.
Now, this is as far from a welfare program as you can get. We don't disempower anybody. And let me tell you something. You give people something when they know they didn't deserve it. You disempower them. You turn them into beggars and dependents. And what we do here is we enable people. We build facilities where they can take a shower so they can get a job. We take kids off the street and educate them. Because let's think about something. What is true power? Knowledge.
You've done a great work. This is very impressive.
All of the money raised goes directly to the projects. Gil doesn't pay accountants or lawyers or secretaries or even Santas on Harleys.
Yeah, I have learned this from Gil. I'm not saying I live it every day, but that the reason we're here as human beings is to serve others.
You guys are the future of our planet, and you've got a big job.
Gil's dream continues with these American kids. Rancho Feliz has built a dormitory next to the orphanage and old folks' home so Americans can come and serve. He calls it a win-win situation.
We help them with their material poverty, and by doing so, our kids get helped with their, what I call, spiritual poverty or purpose poverty, if you will.
Most people, they take it for granted, especially teenagers, that when they go to the fridge, they're going to open it, there's going to be a fridge full of food.
You know, these people are living in a room, a house the size of my room, and my room is bigger than their house, you know. So I'm really grateful for that.
Gil's guardian warriors are spreading his simple message. The rat race can steal a part of your soul. Service work can give it back.
If you want to be happy, bar none, here's the answer. Service.
I brought this design back from Tibet, and what it means and what it represents, it's the endless knot, it's the interconnectedness of all mankind, and it represents the illusory nature of time, which we can contemplate while we're writing. So anyway, I'm going to pass these around. Everybody take one.
So one of the things we're going to do this year, we are going to start a journal, and every night at dinner, we are going to pass the journal around, person to person to person. And you don't, I mean, if you don't want to write anything, that's fine. We just want your impression of the day, something that happened to you. What kind of day was it? What we're going to do is at the end of the ride, we're going to have this all copied off and bound into a book. And we're going to send it to everyone. So you can look, keep in mind, when you make your comments, everybody else is going to be together too.
Joyce had the camera tonight, or today, and Joyce put your name on the camera, so when we get them developed, you'll tell the story of what you saw through your eyes for the race.
And then tomorrow, I'll pick somebody else to be the designated photographer for the trip and put your name on it. And then we'll, when we get them developed, you get to critique what you saw the trip through your eyes that day.
Part of the intent on this trip for me is to do some writing, but I'm also here to donate my services and do some massage work. And I think what I'm going to do, I have a sign-up sheet. Probably between 4 and 8 people a day, probably 15 minutes apiece.
Joyce, the very first recipient. Come on up. Tomorrow you must wear this. And it is absolutely, you know, because most jerseys have like canvas. It's a margarita emblazoned across. So you get the first. Now that
it's not big enough.
Well, sure, it'll fit here. No, and actually,
I won't be able to breathe tomorrow.
No, and actually, we have a larger one for you if you would like. Would you like?
People are smiling. Dennis is walking. Amazing.
I feel great.
It's a fine morning.
I started thinking about the ride ahead last night.
I woke up at 4.
After yesterday, you know, 8 more freaking days of longer distances. God.
Yeah, I didn't. This.
I was thinking like next
two nights
year,
in a row,
like
I didn't sleep
ballet.
All that well. I'm like.
No, Sally has it. We'll do a square dance-a-thon.
We're going to do a square dance-a-thon.
Tonight?
No, next year's fundraiser. So we're going to take square dancing lessons, and we're going to sit around the little red and white tablecloths.
You know, I was thinking a chess tournament would be in order.
We're going to sit. Okay, I don't know why I think.
Now we're going to be in trouble.
Like 250?
It's good, though.
Yeah, let's pick that up.
Good for your system.
Eating stuff that I would never eat at home.
You're bad. You're bad. Whoops.
I'm really bad.
Yeah, don't you ever give me shit about my clothes.
Oh, it's like, oh, no, we gotta go.
It's a chick thing.
Oh, wait.
You run into Interstate 70, and then you hook on 70 for a little bit and ride into the... No, you won't get on the freeway. You go right underneath and get right into town, Green River, right downtown. You'll find Ray's Tavern.
Okay? On the right.
How far
on the right.
Tug of war, those are always fun. We raise money to a tug of war.
An 8-day tug of war? Tug of war across the state of Arizona. Greaser and chain oil, that'd be great. If not, we can find some in Moab, I'm sure. Thanks, Todd, and we're really looking forward to seeing you. Adios.
You know, we didn't
get a newspaper.
On the ride.
Keep going, keep going.
There's nothing like it. I honestly don't know if we're doing this for ourselves or for the kids.
Scaling Water said, as do the bicyclists. They are proud to serve those less fortunate than Tilburg said, and the journey is worthwhile as well. The people you meet, the difference you make, it's a great experience, she said. I've never done a long trek. I'm sure I'll be last, but
is
I wouldn't miss it.
All right.
Taxi Depot donations can be sent to Ranch Police Charitable Foundation, blah, blah, blah.
Oh, I gotta read that later.
Front page.
Oh, my God.
And on that, yeah. That's on the Dairy Road.
This is it.
You guys has any kind of, do you have any kind of a rally shout or anything like that?
I'm pre-disaster. There's nothing else can happen to me. Well, I mean, what's left? I've had four flats in a day, and I crashed. I figure I'm safe. Hell, I bet I can ride off a cliff, and I'm going to end up back on the road because I'm pre-disaster.
Oh man. Okay, we got 70 miles from landing. We hit landing. We're going to be a third of the way. I don't know if that's 70, 80, what the hell. But, yeah. But that's the good news. The bad news is that the vast majority is uphill. You should have 27 flats on this trip. You keep your average up. And three more crashes. He'll be scab, man.
Dennis and I looked at a map of the United States, and compared to where we're going, we haven't really gone all that far. It was depressing.
Let's win, JP.
Go for it.
All right. Hey, we had a bunch of big hills today. A lot of effort, you guys. A third day out. And I just cannot wait until we ride across that border into Agua Prieta and you see, because of all the work and all the energy that you put out and the donations you've collected and the t-shirts we sold, we'll be able to take two or three of these precious children in off the street. We'll be able to get corrective surgeries done for them. We'll actually be able to fill up that orphanage with 50 kids because of everything that you've done. In the spirit of the real modern day warrior, I want to congratulate everybody here, and I'd like to just get some ideas of what this has meant to y'all so far. Any comments?
Listen, I was talking to Mike, and all of us have a choice how to spend this week. We could go sit on a beach somewhere. We could do a lot of things that are a lot more comfortable than what we're doing. And as you're coming up these hills, it's a combination of desire and almost feeling personal integrity just for being a part of something like this. It's not, Mike said it, Mike McCreary said it when he said, "I'm not sure whether we're really, you know, whether we're doing this all for the kids or for ourselves too." Because as much good as we're doing for the kids, and it makes my heart proud to do that, the feeling of accomplishment doing this is, I can't even describe it.
The modern day guardian warrior, huh? Energy going both ways.
You know, I was thinking of those little two girls, especially, that I just fallen in love with down there, that Myra and Lupita, and they have the most beautiful smiling eyes, and they give love so freely. They're just always there to give you a hug or give you a kiss, and there's not too many kids on our side of the border that are that giving and loving, but they're so happy to see us down there that they're just thrilled to give us all the kisses we want.
Speaking of our side of the border, I think that's my favorite part of this whole thing is the exchange program, because not only do I get a chance to help out the kids down there in Mexico, but I love the idea of getting American family and American kids.
Absolutely.
Never get a chance to see anything else, to go down there, see what it's like to work, and, you know, gain their own self-respect just by getting a chance to work with those kids and helping out to learn that, you know, maybe being macho isn't beating up somebody else, but helping out somebody else. It takes more strength to do that.
How much of the world lives in that kind of poverty? I mean, two-thirds?
Oh, most of the world. We were blessed to be born where we are, on the right side of that chain-link fence, and it's almost a choiceless obligation that we have to give back. But that's a good point, Sabra. That's helping our own kids here in the United States, giving them something to look at, kind of redefining what the guardian warrior is. Not the Von Dom going around shooting people, but a bunch of people putting out a lot of energy to lift people up that haven't had the same opportunities that we have. How about on this side? Any ideas?
Well, there's a multitude of charities that you can focus on throughout your life, and I think we all are focusing our energies on Rancho Feliz, but I would like to mention the fact that I appreciate my friendship with Gil tremendously, so that my sphere of influence can interact with his sphere of influence and bring all these people together and focus the energy, and our focus is Rancho Feliz right now. It could be something else in the future if somebody else has a charity or an event, something that they want to get this much energy from this kind of people and group of peoples together. It's nice to be able to pick up the phone and call on each other and know that people will be dependable.
Absolutely. It's a big family. After this trip, we're going to be kind of attached at the hips.
although Dennis is up for adoption, isn't he?
Yeah.
That's actually the wing.
That's why we're expanding the orphanage, so we can put Dennis in there.
To show the kids it could be worse.
Yeah. If you don't want to grow up to be like this, listen to Gil.
I think the thing about Rancho Feliz that appeals to people is it's at such a grassroots level that you can go down to the border and see right where 100% of your time and money and donations are spent. And it's not like donating to an ivory tower where you're not sure where the money filters down to or what good it does, if any. But you go down to the orphanage and all our efforts and all our money and all our good thoughts are right there in front of you. You can touch it and feel it. And that's what I really like about it.
We found that a lot of the people that were trying to put donations into effort, as I had the brochure, this one lady said, "Now, how much of this money actually goes to the children?" I said, "All of it." "Well, then, how did you make this beautiful brochure?" I said, it's donated. Everything is donated. Talents and time and effort by people.
And radio guys.
Everything, all of these different pieces of the pie come together to make it whole. And there were a lot of people that were really excited about that. It was totally donation and selfless.
You know what I like about it, Jackie? Is that this kind of a group, Rancho Feliz, you could do anything. I mean, there's so many different aspects of this where you can give and be a warrior. It's as creative as you want to get. You can do it.
The other thing, we have so much energy in this group, but we have equally that same amount with the people that help out across the border. Kitta and the Amarillas and all those people that are so wonderful on that other side.
Right.
Keep it so well organized.
Make it happen.
Right. And that's what's particularly exciting, because we're working in service here, and we're going to be able to go across the border and see all that's been built, the completion of 4,000 square foot dormitory, and all that's been done by our energy. You know, it's interesting, because if you can imagine it, you can create it. And that's what we're doing here. We, we're taking a portion of our lives and we're saying, hey, this world needs some changes. And instead of complaining about it and saying we're victims and blaming the government, we're getting off our dead asses and putting them on a bike seat and making a difference.
I can make a difference.
And we can make a difference, and we are making a big difference.
You guys have organized that and allowed us to help out. You know, Kevin and Jackie and Bill. There are so many people. You know, we're also appreciative because you've allowed us to figure out a way to channel our energy into helping out these people. And there are so many people that would love to do that, and you've made it easy for us. So, well, thank you all for that.
Although most of our friends think we are out of our minds.
Right, well, that's different.
You have friends?
Yeah. Okay, acquaintance.
Plural for them.
I just come to be humbled, and it's working.
Okay.
So how many more miles we got? Yeah.
How many more hills?
Cheer.
How many more
mountains? Huh?
One more Rancho.
One more Rancho Feliz cheer.
Rancho Feliz Guardian Warrior.
That's full blossom.
Great.
Right there.
That gets a lot worse.
It's a potpourri of color.
You bet.
Great job. If it gets much worse, I probably will.
Bruising is dead blood.
You know?
Killing more blood, you've got a problem.
For me, it's
easy. Be sore.
Thanks, Jack.
I'm sorry, man.
We feel better now.
Yeah, well, you're
taking a... We feel a lot better.
All right, boys, let's go. Hard bus.
Here, why don't you take it?
Cannibalize some of these bikes in here. You don't even know he's there. Just kick him. So he's like debris in the park.
We used to ski.
Macaroni!
Drive
back.
Oh, I heard that place is really grown.
Yeah.
What's the elevation?
Well, those downhills with that headwind.
Tell me when.
Over six.
Okay, Marcy, what's your plan?
Pretty well, I think. That's good.
That's
thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Back on that bike, and you ride that right in the frickin' car. You hear me?
Okay.
No, because Kite's telling him he's in the vehicle.
That's not what we
Leonard's
know.
That kind of guy.
Just tell Charlie Bell.
That high sprung. There you go.
Dennis, if you want to go ahead, man, go for it.
All right, buddy.
I'll pick you up. I passed a captain going downhill. The cop passed me and shook his head.
Gun on you?
Oh, I thought he was going to pull me over because I passed him on the right and I was just about to go vapor. You know, just about.
Oh, where'd you find that, Bob? My friend Bob.
Last one, sweetie.
No, we got a Bud Light.
Oh, yeah, but you don't have a Michelob. They don't have any more beer. They got a Bud Light.
Yeah. That's
good. I'll take it.
You guys are just sick. You need help. You need therapy.
Ow! Ow!
Hiking through borders 850 miles from Salem, Utah to Douglas, Arizona, supported by amateur radio.
Why would it be that if anybody rides 850 miles is a little bit crazy? Would you spend 850 miles on a bicycle seat?
Chronologically, it's only 9 days. The wear and tear of my body. I'm about to die. I'm 72. I could be carbon tested. If you cut off my arm right now and did a carbon test, I'm about 300 years old.
So why go through it all?
It's just important. It's important for us. It's important for the kids.
I always like Doc said.
Gonna have a doctor's rhythm.
That'd be good.
How long have you been riding?
Oh, about 5 years now.
Last year they kept saying, we gotta do something simpler, something easier.
I was into a wind on a hill, and I was so frustrated, so demoralized, I just had tears coming down my face. I just saw no end to it. It was relentless. And yet, at the top of that particular hill, I can say I've never felt more alive.
Woo-wee! The adrenaline's too much, but we gotta get there. I'm just gonna explode.
We'll be right back.
I like the idea of helping out an orphanage. I really like the idea of the exchange programs that they have.
An hour, I'll do it, but never again.